Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Distinguished delegates. I would like to forward my gratitude for following me to share my views and opinions. Some may find them harsh, but the reality must prevail. What is right is right. What is wrong is wrong. It must be on record to form a path of history. For those who do not know me, I am Altaf Hussain. A Pakistani born in Karachi, Pakistan. I formed my movement as a student in 1978 in Karachi University of Pakistan. Under the name of APMSO, All Pakistan Mohajir Students Organizations, to attain the rights of Mohajir students who were persistently denied admissions into professional and educational institutions for higher education. I then went on to form a progressive, liberal and democratic political party called the Mohajir Qaumi Movement, MQM, in 1984, to raise the voice of all legislative forums, including the Provincial Assembly, National Assembly, and the Senate of Pakistan, to present all those who have been and are still oppressed by Pakistani military controlled regimes. Unfortunately, there are more than 200 countries in the world, but all the countries have their own army. But there is only one country, that is Pakistan, which has no army, but army has the country, that is Pakistan. So let me clarify about Mohajirs. What is the meaning of Mohajirs? Who are Mohajirs? Mohajirs are those who migrated to Pakistan after the partition of British India in 1947. And they migrated from India to Pakistan in 1947. However, the native means who have been living before the partition in Pakistan, never accepted those who migrated and who were termed as Bhaiya, Matarwa, Tiliya, Makka, very, very derogatory words, and Mohajirs. So they were never ever, the Mohajirs who migrated to Pakistan, never ever accepted as the sons of the soil since the inception of Pakistan, after the partition of British India in 1947. It may seem strange to you, but the undeniable truth is that I have been banned. I would like to appeal you, to request you, to kindly pay attention, that Altaf Hussain, the leader of over 70 million people of Mohajirs and all other oppressed nationalities of Pakistan. It is amazing that I have been banned to speak to my millions of people. My millions of followers. The government of Pakistan has placed a media ban on me, totally ban on me. My voice, my photos, my name cannot appear in any print media, print or electronic media, not only print, but as electronic media as well, which is used to express one's voice. Here, I want to ask, what was my crime to implement such a ban? I raised my voice against all the injustices being meted out against Mohajirs and other oppressed nations of Pakistan. However, I am not only leader who has spoken against the state injustices, brutalities. Many other leaders also in Pakistan have criticized the state about these brutalities and injustices, but not a single action was taken against them because they are regarded as sons of the soil. Sons of the soil. But this is very unfortunate. We have not yet been recognized as sons of the soil since the very inception of Pakistan in 1947. Up till now. I was forced into exile in 1992. Many attempts were made to assassinate me. Oh, not only me, but this is a reality. It is on record that over 22,000 Mohajirs, you elderly persons, youngsters, have been butchered by the state missionary, but no voice raised by our fellow citizen. This is very, very painful and very unfortunate. Silence prevailed. I was the only voice in Pakistan to speak out to highlight the religious extremism is breeding, and if it is not stopped at the moment, I would say that it will soon take over all Pakistan. This was not light. This was not feel good light by Pakistani military, because all the jihadi outfits are formed by the army, by the ISI, Inter Services Intelligence of Pakistan. Not only the others, I was also subjected to in Pakistan to stop my life. When I didn't stop, they started to use every effort to eliminate me, to finish me, to crush me, to kill me, to assassinate me. Since this is on record that I was, as I told you earlier, that I was forced into exile in 1992. Many attempts were made on my life. Thousands have been brutally killed extrajudicially. Thousands are enforcedly disappeared, and they are incarcerated. Thousands are incarcerated in different prisons, in different jails of Pakistan. But none of them have been any arrested people or enforced disappeared people have been produced before any court of law of Pakistan, including the Supreme Court. Those parents whose loved ones were enforcedly disappeared from their houses in their prisons went to Supreme Court of Pakistan and back to the judges of the Supreme Court to recover our loved ones. But this is very, very unfortunate that even the highest court of Pakistan, that is the Supreme Court, didn't pay any attention to the plight of the crying mothers and fathers and the family members. Since 2013, Mohajirs once again have been the subjected of an intense military-led crackdown. Over 84 extrajudicial killings have been taking place. Round about, but I would like to say over 450 have been the subjects of enforced disappearances, and thousands are languishing arbitrary detentions without access to their due rights. Their only crime allegiance to the MQM and me, Altaf Hussain. I am speaking from the United Kingdom, UK, a country that respects one's human rights. Unfortunately, Pakistan, being the signatory to the United Nations since very inception, has completely disregarded all conventions, completely ignored and disregarded all conventions of the United Nations. All the resolutions have been denied. They didn't take notice of any resolutions passed by the United Nations to respect the human rights by Pakistani establishment, military establishment, or the regime's military controlled regimes. The United Nations, I request you, must, this is my request, must ensure that Pakistan is held accountable for the actions. Pressure must be applied by member states to ensure that Pakistan stop violating one's rights, which is not only afforded by the United Nations conventions, but enshrined in the constitution of Pakistan. The atrocities which are being carried out by the state go beyond any one's imagination. In fact, the amount of war crimes, ethnic cleansing, genocide amounts to a war crime. Those corrupt military generals and military personnel who support and implement must be held accountable as war criminals. They must be tried before the ICJ, International Court of Justice. I request member states to support me and my deprived Mohajirs, people, and other oppressed nations. Help us, please. Help us to bring these criminals to justice. Mass murderers must be held accountable. The United Nations is an independent platform of states by which all share and hold those responsible to account, responsible for these atrocities, brutalities, and injustices. I request the United Nations to hold an urgent summit and place Pakistan before those responsible and seek answers from them. Finally, may I take this opportunity to raise the concern of my fellow Balochs, Pashtuns, and the people from FATA, federally administered tribal areas, FATA. I am steadfast and I am fully aware of the ethnic cleansing which is being carried out against them. Till my last breath, I will not remain silent. There I speak for the Mohajirs. I will speak for all those who are oppressed by the tyrants, irrespective of their ethnic belongings, religious belief, caste, color, or creed. You have me to raise your light. I would like to come to an end. And thank you all for taking a few moments to listen to the cries of all Mohajirs and other oppressed nations, and all oppressed people of Pakistan, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Once again, thank you very much.
With that heavy round of applause, it indicates that he has actually touched the heart of many here. And we are happy that we have provided this space for him to, for once, be able to express himself and directly to the United Nations. I'm sure they have taken note. From his statement, we have got about heavy military operations that continue to restrict the rights of people. We have heard about military tribunals. And to me, it sounds like any proceedings before the military tribunals is totally against the Geneva Convention that relates to warfare, and therefore should be declared null and void. Simple. And again, we have heard how people are constantly riding on the right of others. And by doing so, let those who are doing it know that they are riding on a lion. And the moment you will drop down, the lion will devour you. Whether we like or not, it happens every day. We have heard about prisons, and you would imagine the prison's condition. It is like that in much of the developing countries. So it sounds to me as if people living in developing countries are cursed. Back in my own land, Cameroon, as a human rights defender who have had the opportunity to work with prisons through our program Access to Justice for Prisoners, we have cried loud that they should carry out prison reform. But those who are supposed to do it, they don't do it. And today, many of them are in prison, that very prison. So this is to say that if you think that you can remove a bridge for somebody to cross, remember tomorrow you will need that bridge to cross. And on this note, we come to the end of our side event. And we thank all the participants for having taken